Hi friends, welcome back to Hobby Plus. Today our discussion matter is optocoupler. Optocoupler means this device connected by light. So this is called optocoupler. That is your transistor collector and that is your transistor emitter and that is your base which is connected with a lead. So this is secondary to primary are separated, but we can handle from primary to secondary with the light. So this is called optocoupler. When you use your optocoupler, then you must follow the data sheet of this number. This is very important number because each and every device has almost 817, but the front two alphabet is different. So these data sheet are not same. Now we are trying to read the data sheet for drive this optocoupler. Look at this. The forward current is 50 milliamps, that is input, that means diode part, and peak forward current is 1 ampere, reverse voltage is 6 volt. Not only that, we have to learn one more thing. Look at this, the peak forward voltage 3 volt and forward voltage is 1.2 volt, max 1.4 volt. So we can calculate this value, I mean 3.0 volt. For that we have to design a network for this. Now when we make this circuit, then we have to calculate the resistance network. Look at this, that is your lower, that is your upper arm and that is your lower arm. This resistance and R1 resistance and R2 resistance are in network. So we have to calculate this value for this device. How can we calculate this value? Come here. Ampere calculation. First we have to calculate the ampere. In the data sheet we follow the ampere is 50 millivolt, but I calculate this value 30 millivolt. Why? I will tell you, and you also understand why this value I take 30 milli. Suppose that is your 30 millivolt, that means 0.03 ampere, and that is your input voltage. 12 is your input voltage. So V divided by I is equal to R. So 12 volt is your V. 0.03 is your I, that means 400 resistance is the total resistance of this network. R1 plus R2, I already show that. R1 and R2. Now how can we divide the resistance for 3 volt? Come here. Input voltage is to output voltage. What is our input voltage? That is 12, and our target output voltage is 3. That means 4:1 is our ratio. When we use the total resistance, that means 400 ohms, we have to divide 400 ohms by the 4. 400 divided by 4 equals to 100 ohms. Right? We get our lower arm, that is your lower arm value. That means your higher arm value, is 400 minus 100 equals to 300 ohms. Fine. That is your higher arm. So your network resistance value is 300 R, and lower arm is 100 R. We can easily calculate the output voltage. We can easily calculate the upper arm and the lower arm, and also this resistance network provide you 0.03 ampere, which is better for our optocoupler. Now, why I tell you 0.03 amps? Because you cannot get in the market in any time 300 resistance. You can get 330 ohms, you can get 390 ohms. So you can arrange your device network with this resistance, that is always in the limit of the input voltage and current. So I take this something like that. Now our second part is output. We are now going to discuss about output. See this. This is important. Collector emitter voltage is 80 volt. Emitter collector voltage is 6 volt, that means reverse voltage. Collector current is 50 milliamps. So we cannot get more than 50 milliamps from this device, more than 80 volt from this device. So we have to calculate same thing for our output. Remember that. So we cannot use this value except, sorry, we cannot use this higher than 80 volt and 50 milliamps. When you design your network, when you design this SMPS circuit or isolation circuit, then you have to use this data for your better performance. Thank you. Thank you for watching.